Dear students, prep 2, this is the rest of our novel Jane Eyre, page 8. The first phase in Jane's life was with her aunt, Mrs. Reed, and her three cousins. The second phase was at Lowood School. She stayed at Lowood School for a long time. When she was 18 years old, she left the school and she worked as a governess at a new place called Thornfield Hall. It was a new place and new characters. She's going to face new faces. Okay? Page 8. One afternoon, I walked to the village to post a letter. It was winter and there was ice on the road. As I was walking back to Thornfield Hall, I heard a noise behind me. It was a horse. A man was riding towards Thornfield Hall. I stood on one side and the horse went past. The man did not see me. He was a stranger with dark hair. Stranger because this is the first time for Jane to see anyone walking in this area. She has been working at Thornfield Hall and she hasn't met except Mrs. Fairfax, the housekeeper there, teaching the little girl Adele, the French girl. She was teaching her English and a lot of servants. And this was the first time for her to meet this man. Suddenly, with a loud noise, the stranger's horse fell down on the ice. The man was lying on the ground, trying to get up. I ran forward to help. This is the first time for Jane to see this man. That's why she said the stranger. And this is the first time to help him. "Are you hurt, sir?" I asked him. The stranger looked surprised to see me. Later on, we are going to know why did he look surprised. "A little," he answered. "Could you help me to catch my horse?" "That's right. Now could you bring the horse here, please?" "Thank you." The stranger tried to stand up, but his leg was hurting too much. He looked at me again. "Could you help me to get up on its back again?" "Good. Thank you, miss." I watched him as he rode away. "Who is he?" I asked myself. "He is not handsome, but he has an interesting face. I would like to know him." This is the first impression for Jane after seeing this man. She didn't know his name. She found him charming a little bit, that she wished that she could see him again. When I got back to Thornfield, everybody was very excited. Mrs. Fairfax was very busy. "What's happening?" I asked her. When Jane returned to Thornfield Hall, she found everybody buzzing, busy, doing a lot of things, cooking, decorating the house, preparing food. Everyone was busy and at the same time excited. So glad. "Oh, Miss Eyre," said Mrs. Fairfax. Mrs. Fairfax, she is the housekeeper at Thornfield Hall. "It is Mr. Rochester." This is the first male character. This is the first male character in our story. "He has suddenly come back, but he will probably go away again soon." This means what? That Mr. Rochester is the owner of Thornfield Hall. Okay? Not Mrs. Fairfax. Mr. Rochester is the owner of Thornfield Hall. And this is the first time for Jane to see him, as she thought. So everyone was preparing and decorating the house for his arrival. "Now, Miss Eyre, you must go and put on your best dress. Mr. Rochester wants to meet you and Adele after dinner. Adele is the little girl that Jane was teaching her English. Later that evening, I took Adele to Mr. Rochester's room. I felt rather afraid of meeting Mr. Rochester. I went quickly into the room and saw a man there. I knew him. It was the man on the horse. So the interesting stranger was Mr. Rochester. As I told you, Jane wished to see this man again. And this is the second time for her to see him. And she realized that he was the owner of Thornfield Hall. She was so excited. Mr. Rochester did not go away again. He was busy every day. But sometimes in the evenings, he talked to me. He was usually serious and he did not smile or laugh very often. My students, this is Jane's point of view of Mr. Rochester. Mr. Rochester is the hero in our novel, in our story. Okay? But this is her opinion of him. That he's not handsome, but fine, charming, he's serious, he's not cheerful, most of the time, rough, so this is her point of view, and we will see later. Thank you so much for listening. Okay, as I told you, Jane here, she saw Mr. Rochester, and she realized that he was the owner of Thornfield Hall. And her point of view was that he was serious and he doesn't smile or laugh very often. But he was very interesting and I was not afraid of him. I began to enjoy myself more at Thornfield Hall. At the beginning, when Jane went to Thornfield Hall to work as a governess teaching Adele, she found life was boring and dull there. She taught Adele for a while, then she had a lot of free time doing nothing. So she went for a walk and came back. She didn't feel interested. So when she saw Mr. Rochester and Mr. Rochester went to live there at Thornfield Hall, she was more excited because he invited his friends. There were parties every day. There were a lot of guests. That's why she felt much happier. Okay. One night, I woke up suddenly. It was about 2 o'clock in the morning. I thought I heard a sound. Everything was very quiet. I listened carefully and the sound came again. Someone was walking about outside my room. "Who's there?" I called. Nobody answered. I felt cold and frightened. The house was silent. I tried to sleep again. Then I heard a laugh. It was a terrible, cruel laugh. I listened. Someone was walking away, going up the stairs to the attic. What was happening? I decided to go and find Mrs. Fairfax. Here we have suspense. Jane here, she went to sleep. Then she heard someone in the corridor walking, passing her room. Then suddenly she heard someone laughing, okay? She is curious to know what was going on. I put on some clothes and left my room. The house was quiet now. Quiet because all the house, all the servants, all the people inside Thornfield Hall had slept. The house was quiet now. But suddenly, I could smell smoke. Something was burning. I ran to find out. She found there was smoke in the corridor So she ran quickly in order to see what was going on. The smoke was coming from Mr. Rochester's room. I ran into the room and looked around. Mr. Rochester was asleep in his bed, and the bed was on fire. What can I do? I thought. Quickly, I looked around the room. Luckily, there was some water in one corner. As quickly as I could, I took the water and threw it all over the bed. Mr. Rochester woke up. What's happening? He shouted. Jane, is it you? What are you doing? My dear students, this is the second time for Jane to help Mr. Rochester. Could you remember the first time when she saw him while she was walking to post the letter and he fell down his horse? She helped him. This is the second time to help him, okay? When she heard the sound, there was smoke coming from his bed and he was going to die while he was sleeping. So she rescued him. So this is the second time to save Mr. Rochester's life. Mr. Rochester, I said, your bed is on fire. You must get up at once. He jumped out of bed. There was water everywhere and the fire was still smoking. Jane, you have saved me from the fire. How did you know about it? Why did you wake up? Mr. Rochester asked. I told him about the noise outside my door and the terrible laugh. Mr. Rochester looked serious and angry. I must go upstairs to the attic. Stay here and wait for me, please. Do not wake Mrs. Fairfax. He left the room and I waited for him. My dear students, starting from this point, there is suspense in our story. Who made the fire? There are a lot of questions that we don't know at this moment. For instance, as I told you, who made the fire? Who was laughing this terrible laugh? Why did he become angry? And he asked Jane not to follow him and he went upstairs to the attic. Who was on the attic? All these questions need answers. Okay? As I told you, there is suspense in the story. And he asked Jane not to inform anyone about what had happened. At last, he came back. He was still looking very serious. You can go back to bed now, Jane. Everything is all right now. This means that Mr. Rochester went upstairs to the attic. Then he came back to Jane. Then asked her to go to bed and sleep and forget everything that had happened. And of course, not to tell anyone. Who lives in the attic? I asked Mrs. Fairfax the next day. As I told you, Jane Eyre is curious. She wants to know what's going on. Who is living upstairs? Only Grace Poole, she answered. Who is Grace Poole? She is one of the servants. She is a strange woman. So Mrs. Fairfax replied to Jane that she is one of the servants. Her name is Grace Poole. She is living on the attic and she is a strange woman. I remembered Grace Poole. She was a strange, silent woman who did not often speak to the other servants. So perhaps it was Grace Poole who walked around the house late at night and laughed strangely outside the doors. That evening when Adele finished her lessons, I went downstairs. Mrs. Fairfax met me. Okay, thank you so much for listening.